Okay, so if you're a Windows user today, I'm going to show you three different tools you can use to record your screen that don't even require you to install anything on your Windows PC. Let's go. If I do a search for screen recorder, there's really nothing there to be found. It can give me some pointers in terms of ads for third-party software, but that's about it in terms of what's in Windows. So it's not super easy to find these things. So if I hit snipping, and snipping tool, that's gonna open up the snipping tool for me. So I'll switch it over to a video mode. And if I hit new, now I can select the area of the screen that I want. In my case, I'll select the entire screen. And from there, all you have to do is hit start. That's gonna count you down. And then from there, it's going to start recording your screen. Now note that the little window up top with the recording bar isn't gonna be part of your recording, even though it looks like it might be. So I'm just going to do a few kind of quick things on the desktop. So we've got some movement and some motion. I'll open up the browser. I'll close the browser and I'll stop recording. Now what that's going to do is actually show me a preview of the video inside the snipping tool. And if you go and hit the maximize window screen, you can see the entire thing with both taskbars on top of each other. So kind of inception-like in terms of looking at both different videos, but you'll see that it's exactly what I just showed you. Recording everything again, except for the little window on top that I'm actually pressing here to stop the recording. So it doesn't get that information in the video, which is a good thing. And what you'll do now after this is you'll save the video. You can give it a name. By default, it's going to go into your videos folder as an MP4 file. And now you have the video as an MP4 to share or edit or do whatever you want to do with it, upload it to YouTube, etc. So now I'm gonna go ahead and close this out. And the next thing I wanna show you is another option. So you can search for the game bar in Windows Start. So I'll go ahead and search for game bar and I can open that. And there's another way to open this up that I'll show you in a second. And you'll see that there's quite a few different menus and things floating over the screen again, kind of like last time. Now, if I try to record from the desktop or from the File Explorer, it doesn't let me. But if I've got an application open, like Edge in my case, I can record. So let me open up Edge and I'll hit Windows key plus G this time to bring up the game bar. So it's the same screens and overlays that you saw before, but now the record button is available to me. So I'll go ahead and hit that and you can see another recording pop up here. And I have now everything recording and that stays there in terms of being able to stop the recording later. So kind of like last time, I'm going to go ahead and do a couple of things on screen just so you can see some movement and some motion. So I'm in outlook.com now and I'll go ahead and stop the recording and you'll see that it's stopped and I have now the file. If I want to go and find the file, what I can do is actually again go into the game bar and pull up all of those menu options. So I'm going to go into the widgets menu here. This time I'm going to open up gallery. Now gallery is going to show me the file I just recorded. The newest one will be on top. And I'll go ahead and play that one too, just to make sure that everything is the same as I recorded it. So I started out again, because I need an app open in the Edge browser in my case. And I went to outlook.com, so I'll go ahead and show that. But everything it recorded, just like it did more or less in the snipping tool, but this time from the game bar, showing everything within that application that was open. One thing you do notice though, is there's no taskbar visible in this recording. All right, and another thing, if you want to go and find the video that you just recorded, if you go into videos and you go into captures, that is the video that we just recorded there again as an MP4 file. And I keep pointing out it's an MP4 file because the next option I'm going to show you is actually something called Clipchamp. So if you open up the waffle menu next to Outlook and then open up Clipchamp, what that does is it takes you to free recording software. So in our case, we're going to go ahead and create a new video. And that's gonna give us options once we create the new video to be able to capture our screen as well. So I'll go ahead and add media to this as well, and I'll do a screen recording. So here I can choose to allow or not allow the microphone. When I do that, it gives me a record button option. This is kind of like if you use Teams on the web, for example, it's the same mechanism. So here I can record either an Edge browser tab, a full window, or the entire screen. In my case, I'll go ahead and record the entire screen. So I'll select it and I'll hit share. And now I have that recording basically into the Clipchamp recorder. So it looks a little bit inception-y right now. So let's go ahead and close that tab, or move to another tab, I should say. And now I can see that I'm on my email tab. I'll go ahead and hide that screen and hit OK. And now if I move around a bit, just to, again, give some motion to the recording, you can see that I've got my email open in my case, and I can go into the recorder again, get our inception screen, and then hit stop. Now, once I do that, if I hit save and edit, that's going to actually open up the Clipchamp editor. The other thing that it does, though, is it creates the recording of the local file as well. In our case, you'll see that this is a WebM file, W-E-B-M file. So it's a little bit different than a normal, MP4 file. So what you might want to do at this point is actually output this as a video file, as an MP4. So when you go ahead and do that, it's going to create an MP4. Even before I can give it a name, it's going to start outputting that when it's doing the processing of untitled video. That's actually producing this WebM file, in our case, to an MP4. So once that's done, you'll see that it actually pops up and says you can save it right from here, from the downloads in the browser. I'll close that, though, and I'll hit save to my computer. It's doing basically the same thing. This way I can retitle it and save it where I want to. So by default, it looks like it's going to the documents directory, which in my case isn't my preference. I want to go to the videos directory. So I'll go ahead and change the folder over to videos next to my captures folder from my last couple of recordings. And now I've recorded an MP4 to my local drive with my screen recording. And when I go back to the videos folder on my local device, I can go ahead and open the video. And you'll see that our WebM file is now an MP4 file, and it plays just like I recorded it. All of our inception goodness there, none of the kind of overlay screen recording dialogues except for this one in the browser here, and everything else is just as you saw before while I was recording. So that's another free option, again, without installing anything. We just use the browser in our case to record a video. Okay, so hopefully this helps in terms of two different ways to record your screen at full fidelity. Two of those are just built into Windows, the snipping tool and the game bar. Of course, there's a few other things that you can do. And because you might be signing into your Windows computer with a Microsoft account, Clipchamp is going to be there as a free option as well to be able to record to a WebM. Then you can produce that as an MP4, or you can add different video and other components to it to create your own video with Clipchamp as another free option. So hopefully this helps. If it does, give me a like. Also subscribe to my channel. And as always, thank you for watching.